So in today's video, we're going to be going over 10 basic signs that you should know that are related to technology. And so the signs that I'm going to be sharing with you today are primarily taken from a video that Bill Vickers did on the same subject. And I'm going to leave a link in the description down below and also at the end of this video if you'd like to check it out. And be sure to stay until the end of this video for one bonus sign that will really come in handy. So the first sign today is going to be computer. Primarily, this is done with the C hand shape going up across the forearm like this. And another variation that you might come across is computer up on the forehead. And again, you can check out both of those signs on Bill Vickers' website, lifeprint.com. And I encourage you to go ahead and look up these terminologies and these signs on your own. And LifePrint is an incredible resource to do that. So the second sign is going to be a laptop. And so this is done a couple different ways. Typically, it's done with both palms facing down and you're opening it up like a laptop, just like this. So the third sign that we're going to learn today is a tablet, like an iPad or another tablet-like device. And so for this, you just lay out your palm like your palm is the tablet, and you're going to take your middle finger and you're going to swipe across, like you're just kind of swiping across apps on your tablet. So the next sign is going to be phone. And this actually has several signs depending on what kind of phone you're talking about. Typically, we're talking about our smartphones. So you would kind of have this loose C hand shape, kind of like you're holding your smartphone in your hand and you would just start swiping like this. So this could be smartphone. Another variation that you might come across is if you're using a landline, so one that you physically hold in your hand. And so for that, instead of using the C hand shape, you would actually use the Y hand shape and you would hold it up to your face like this. So you have the earpiece and the mouthpiece for like a phone, a landline phone. The next one is going to be a video phone or any kind of video conferencing. And so this one will typically be like this because this is going to be representing a camera recording. And so you might see this as a camera recording and this is being pointed in the direction that you're recording. So I'm recording myself or the video is recording you. So video calls, it goes both ways. So you have cameras connecting both sides of the conversation. And so there are a couple signs depending on what kind of video conferencing or video phone that you're using. If you're using a video phone or VP, most will just do VP for video phone. And then another one might be FaceTime. So you could be holding up the phone and you could do FT for FaceTime or FaceTime. So you will see multiple variations of that, but those are just a couple of the ones that you might want to be familiar with. Moving down to number six on our list today is YouTube. Many of us are watching YouTube more than ever, and there's a couple signs for it. One of the more popular signs for this is YouTube. So it's with the Y and it goes around like this, or another common variation of that is just YT for YouTube. So another sign that you might want to be familiar with is a sign for movie. And like many other signs, there are multiple variations to this. The most common one these days is probably this one right here, where you have this palm facing upward and then you have this palm going back and forth. Another common variation to that is where the palm is really laying flat, or you have a fist and then this is going back and forth. But you can kind of see a pattern to where most of them look very similar to each other. Number eight on our list today is Google. So there are many that will go ahead and finger spell out Google. But another common way of signing that is actually with G's, where you're making the sign for search, like you're looking something up or you're searching for something. But because it's Google, you use the G's. And this is kind of a good example of an English initialized sign where they're using the first letter of the word incorporated into the sign itself. So Google or Google. So number nine on our list is actually iPhone. So we've talked about this being the sign for a smartphone. You could just hold it out like this, or you could start swiping through your phone. But iPhone actually has its own sign. So some people will still fingerspell it, but a common sign that people will use is this, where you have the I up near your ear, iPhone. There is a sign for Android. It's not very common, and I haven't seen it very often out in the wild. But I have seen Bill Vickers videos sign Android like this. But again, it's not very common, at least not to what I've seen. So yeah, iPhone or Android. So let me know in the comments, are you an iPhone person or are you an Android person? We have one last sign as part of our 10 basic signs, and then that bonus sign coming up. So number 10 is download. So we're constantly having to download new things. And so there's a couple signs for it. And so there's one where you're pulling information kind of down from the cloud, download. And another one would be this, to where you have that CL4 classifier hand shape, and it's the flow of information coming from the top down to the bottom. So you either pull it from the cloud or it's flowing down to you for download. So before we get to that last bonus sign, if you found this video helpful, please leave a like and consider subscribing to the channel and click that bell so you'll be notified the next time that we come out with new videos in the future. So without further ado, that bonus sign is going to be Zoom. This is something that we are probably all sick of at this point, but it's something that we probably use on a daily basis. And so there's three common ways of signing it. Typically, most will still fingerspell it Zoom, either with a double O or a slide O. So Zoom or Zoom. A second way, and it's not used anymore, but it was like this, where it looks like a car kind of parking into a garage. But the most common way is this, and this is another sign that you can actually find from one of Bill Vickers' videos, and I believe Neil DeMarco also uses that sign as well. So basically what this is showing is all those little squares, those video feeds, and it's just, you know, those little boxes that go all the way across your screen in that grid. So Zoom. So basically you can fingerspell it. You have this one, which isn't used as much anymore, and then this one. So those are three variations for the sign for Zoom. And if you missed any signs, or if there are any words that you would like to learn that I didn't cover today, please let me know down in the comments down below, and perhaps I can cover those in a future video. Maybe perhaps social media terms, Instagram and Facebook and TikTok, like what are the signs for those? If that's something that you're interested in, please let me know, and I can go ahead and make a video on that topic as well. So I'm going to go ahead and leave a link to that video that I had mentioned prior, to where Bill Vickers goes through a few dozen words that are about technology. And I'll leave that link in the description down below and also at the end of this video, so you can just click it and go ahead and continue to build up your vocabulary. So if you would like to continue to learn more vocabulary, I'm going to leave a link to a playlist of all of the lessons that I've done so far over here. And if you would like to learn how you can become fluent faster, I'm going to leave a link to a playlist where I discuss just that over here. So until next time, I'll see you later. Bye.